Hey guys, I'm going to jump in here for a second on the post edit just to tell you that I originally filmed this video doing calculations for both granular and liquid applications, and that ended up being about a 25 minute long video. So what I'm going to do is split this into two different videos. The first one, we'll talk about calculations for granular fertilizer, and then later in the week I'm going to release a second video on doing calculations for liquid fertilizer, so stay tuned for that one. But right now, let's jump back into this one. Hey guys, so this week I thought we'd talk about fertilizer in a little bit more depth, and more specifically, how do you do the calculations on fertilizer? You know, there's lots of math out there and it can be really confusing, and so I thought I'd help break all this down for you to help you understand, you know, when you're at the box store looking at different bags of fertilizer, trying to determine what to buy, how do you understand what's what? And so when you're in the box store, you've got all these different bags, they all have different NPK ratios, they all are different prices, and some say they'll cover 2,500 square foot, some say they'll do 5,000, some say they'll cover 15,000. So, you know, how do you know what you're getting? How much nitrogen per 1,000 pounds square foot are you actually getting? So today I want to help break down that math. And so I've got some fertilizer here that's pretty common to all of us. That's the Scott's fertilizer, starter fertilizer. I've got a bag of Milorganite here. I've got some liquid fertilizer here. This is the classic 1836 that I've told you guys previously that I really like a lot. And here's a bottle of some of the next product line. This is their green pop that's 16212. And so we'll talk about how you calculate granular, how you calculate liquid, because liquid's a whole nother ball game. And so to start out with, let's just break it down with the granular, which is what most of you guys use. You know, think for a minute. You're at the box store. You're looking at the shelves, everything up there has a different NPK ratio. The labels all say different things, they're all different prices, so how do you know what you're getting? You know, let's take the starter fertilizer for example. In a typical starter fertilizer, you're gonna have three things in common. That's gonna be a high value of nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. So those three elements are gonna be a lot higher in a starter fertilizer, and that's what you want in a starter fertilizer. You want that to be high because it helps kickstart your seed, or, you know, if you've got a lawn that's really lacking in nutrition, sometimes starter fertilizer can really give it a big jump and a big boost to help even out some of the different levels of elements in your soil. Starter fertilizer is expensive because of that very fact. NPK's ratio is a little bit higher in these bags. So how do you understand how much it's covering and, you know, what you're getting for your price? So this little bag of Scott's starter fertilizer, this is just a little 15 pound bag, and its NPK value is 24, 25, 4. And to start out with, how do we know how many pounds of nitrogen per 1,000 square feet you're actually getting on the ground? So to do that, the math is simple. You just take the weight of the bag, it's marked on the bag, so this one's 15 pounds, and you multiply that times your nitrogen value, and the nitrogen value on this bag is 24. So you take 15 pounds of this bag times 0.24, so that's 24% is nitrogen. And that's going to tell you that it's 3.6 pounds. Okay, so this entire bag has 3.6 pounds of nitrogen in this 15 pound bag. So to get that down to per 1,000 square foot, the bag says it'll cover 5,000 square feet. So you take your 3.6 and you divide that by 5, and that's going to give you 0.72. So 0.72 is very close to 0.75. which means you're getting real close to 3/4 of a pound of nitrogen per 1,000 square foot on your lawn from the recommended label rate on this bag. Let's do the same thing on Milorganite, okay? We all use Milorganite at some point or another. And I want to tell you why a lot of us like Milorganite. A lot of us have found that's not the fix-all for everything. And the reason for that is its NPK value is a 620. And so what has happened for a lot of folks is in different parts of the U.S., because of the 2 value, okay, so the phosphorus level, it has increased a lot in people's lawns because they put down so much Milorganite, and it's really made their phosphorus level spike through the roof. Then what you'll find happens is your potassium is a 0, so you have 0 potassium in your lawn. So you've got, you know, if you were to do a soil test, you'd have a kind of a medium level of nitrogen, you'd have a huge spike in phosphorus, and then you'd have a very depleted value of potassium in your lawn if all you're going to use is Milorganite. So don't get me wrong, Milorganite's a great product, but it is not the one you want to use for all year round, because you're going to get your lawn in a in balanced state on the nutrition value. Let's look at this bag. It's a 32 pound bag, and it says that it'll cover 2,500 square feet as well. And so, like I mentioned before, it's a 620, okay? So what you do is you take 32 pounds times 0.06, so 6% of this bag is nitrogen, and that's gonna give you 1.92. And so it says, again, it'll cover 2,500 square feet. So you take 1.92 divided by 2.5, okay? And that's gonna give you 0.76. So again, right there at that 3/4 value of 0.75. So you're gonna get 3/4 of a pound of nitrogen per 1,000 square foot if you follow label rate and cover 2,500 square feet with this product. That is how you figure out, you know, when you're standing at the store and you're looking at these labels and you're trying to figure out how many pounds of nitrogen you're actually getting on your lawn if you follow label rate. Let's look at another scenario, okay, with granular. And that is, what if I don't want to put 3/4 pounds of nitrogen down on my yard? What if I only want to do 1/2 pound, or maybe I want to increase it to 1 full pound? So in that case, what you can do is, let's just use the Morganite for an easy example here. So let's say that I wanted to put 1 pound of nitrogen per 1,000 square foot, okay? So all you have to do is you take the number 100, okay? 100 is gonna be my 1 pound of nitrogen, 1,000 square foot. So you just take 100 and you divide it by your N value, which is a 6 on this bag, and that's gonna give you 16.66. So basically you need 16, or if you wanna call it 17 pounds of this bag, the entire bag, you're gonna need that per 1,000 square foot to cover your lawn with a pound of nitrogen per 1,000. You can adjust that math again. Let's say you only want to do 1/2 pound, right? So I said earlier you take 100 for your 1 pound of nitrogen. If you want to do just 1/2 pound, you could do the value of 50. So you take 50 and divide it by 6. So then you only need 8 pounds of this bag to cover, you know, 1/2 pound rate. So at 8 pounds, 32 pound bag, you're going to get 4,000 square foot out of it if you're going to try to go for 1/2 pound of nitrogen per 1,000. So very easily, that's how you can adjust your math and figure out how many pounds of product you actually need. How many bags do you need? You know, if you want to do a different value than what the label says. And that's very useful if you decide that you want to start doing spoon feeding. So the way a lot of these bags are kind of geared toward is you'll apply fertilizer maybe 4 times a year. Is kind of how the DIY world is in the box store, is they just expect you to do it on the major holidays. And so that's why they recommend you put down 3/4 pound all the time. But let's say, you know, you want your yard to look a lot better than that, like many of you on this channel want to do, you may want to start doing some different types of application rates with doing some spoon feeding. You can vary your application rate by doing, you know, 1/2 pound every couple of weeks. You can do 1/4 pound every couple of weeks, you know, whatever it is that you want to do, whatever works for your yard. You know, you can spoon feed your product in a way that you'll have lasting results and you won't have these variations where your yard looks great for a couple of weeks and it starts to fizzle out because the heat comes in, you get heat stress throughout the summer, you haven't had any nutrition added, and then you fertilize again, it takes off again, and things like that. So to have a more balanced level of nutrition in your lawn, you can do spoon feedings. That's what the golf courses do. That's why it always looks green all the time, because they apply different application rates throughout the season and they don't just fertilize 4 times a year. They keep that on a consistent spoon feeding. You know, spoon feeding, you might spend a little bit more in fertilizer throughout the year, but the results are going to be significantly better than if you just stick to the 4 times a year recommended rates on the bags, that sort of thing. In a nutshell, that's kind of how you can take a look at granular. You can figure out, you know, how many pounds of nitrogen per 1,000 square foot you're actually purchasing in the bag. So when you're doing your comparison on the rack, you can see what you're actually paying for. And then secondly, how you adjust your application rates. So you can spread it out throughout the season to spoon feed it and get more regular applications in.
Alright guys, so I hope that information was helpful for you. Like I mentioned before, stay tuned for the second release of the calculations for doing liquid applications. There's a lot of good information in there that I wish I would have known a long time ago. And so guys, hopefully you enjoyed this one. If you did,
go ahead and like this video. If you haven't already, subscribe to our channel. But I think that's going to do it for this one, guys. We'll see you in the next one.